architecture. In Seoul, it has a very special coexistence of many different historical layers. Context here is so divided that we have to come up with a new way of thinking, of analyzing and creating architecture. Right now, we are in the middle of a transformation and certain explorations are necessary so that we need to take advantage of infinite opportunities. As a matter of fact, it would be impossible to come to a new perspective through a very conventional research and practice method. We must ask ourselves questions and then investigate. There was a book published about the new vision of the city, and this became the starting point of the current way of thinking how architecture should be. The book Compound Body is a kind of architecture that integrates different points of views to open up new possibilities to welcome unexpected new results. Examining the current condition, the whole system, and consider it as an unstable and uncertain environment. So if you think in this way, then the system can produce a series of new opportunities and then actually create creative results. Then architecture can be considered as a system that welcomes, embraces potentials and all the possibilities there are. We cannot limit ourselves from the possibilities, but what we need to do is to expand, rethink and rewrite the foundations of the architectural spaces. The world around us is evolving, changing constantly, and it's shifting between a status of stable and unstable. Architecture must have to face this reality. So this new way of thinking must come from different fields of studies, from numerous resources and origin, the existing connections, and it will always encourage a new interpretation. In the current architectural panorama, there's always an effort to try to develop multidisciplinary relationships to blur the boundaries between different fields. But in order to go a step beyond this, you also need to try to create new personal and unique definitions. So in this system, what is important is to come up with your own definition of logic. So a role as an architect is a mediator, blur the boundaries and combine together different disciplines and try to solve the discrepancies. If you think about traditional architecture, it has always been a tool of a self-identity, but it's not like that anymore. Everything goes online now. The whole world connects as a unity. So you can no longer just talk about one individual value. You start to recognize the world as a unique whole structure, a ground of information. This is a good new opportunity. We can no longer use the simple and conventional way of repeating a certain strategy that you already used. So the spirit of modernization is not a kind of rebellion, but is using a specific point of view to integrate the technology into the space. It's mainly a framework and is integrated with structure, space, materials, landscapes, public spaces. So you can totally imagine that in the future, your space is one single and continuous flow in architecture that is created based on experience or based on a certain narrative, and is blurring the boundaries between inside and outside, between different extremes. It creates an experience that reconnects yourself, your mind, to the dynamics of the city. For example, if you start from an observation of the society and the urban environment around you, you can come up with a solution of interpretation or combination of different elements. The result is not necessarily an individual space, but it can be an integration of different scenarios. The space becomes a single continuous structure that caters infinite sequences. So the goal here is to avoid clear distinctions and try to integrate them as one. So the compound body space is the result of these different substances of spaces. It's just to provide a kind of catalyst to mix the substances. Then you see the result is almost by accident that creates the reaction of this combination. If you think about nanotechnologies nowadays, you will recognize that this web generates new unexpected outcomes and produce transformations. The human beings are being transformed, and men nowadays are no longer what we used to know. We're living in a society that the dimensions like time, space, they evolve, and the human beings have to evolve with them. So how do human beings perceive this society? How do we react to the certain environment? What is the relationships between human beings and the spaces? We have to go one step beyond the modernization. As an architect, the duty is to looking for new approaches, new solutions. All of this could generate new typologies of spaces. So the intention of becoming an animal is an introduction of the Deleuzian fold into an architectural field. So this fold is no longer a form. It is a kind of quality. It is like a reciprocal structure, and it will transform a single flat space into continuity so that it opens up spatial possibilities. For example, why a bathroom cannot be a cafe or a house can be an office as well? This concept is not even so radical anymore. So it is not just the ideal of the architect, but it is the result of this hybridization of daily activities. In this space, the functions are reshuffled according to the demands of the users and the circumstances. So to bring up the challenge, how do we take a given space and try to inject more possibilities to this space? So a self-transforming programs needs to be exploited in order to satisfy this demands of the structure. So the space itself can organize, develop into an arrangement of hybrid programs, different layers of independent forms. So if we take these kind of possibilities into consideration, we will generate new architectural models to combine different programs into a certain architectural space. So the form of the building is not the purpose of the design. There is a much stronger and deeper relationship between the facade and the context around the building. Especially when you think about how people perceive your building and the effect that your building have on them. In reality, it is much deeper. So the facade of the building is just a tool, a method to communicate the architecture between architecture and the city. If you think about the combination of different facades actually affect the quality of the city. It has an impact on the public space around it. But nowadays, even the facade is transformable. It maximizes the possibilities of the facade of the building. The facade has become a subject of discussion in today's architecture. The facade cannot just be a single pattern of solution, but new strategies has to be explored to have a positive impact. So when you look at the city, the skin is actually a combination of different building facades, and it becomes a continuity. So once we've come to understand that this new trend of a mix between what is real and what is virtual, then the concept of the facade could be revolutionized. It opens up new possibilities to enter another dimension. It materializes the skin of the building and becomes a reaction of this double-sided reality. The potential is that the facade of the building becomes a new topology of space. The physical elements such as the structure, columns, beams, walls, floors, windows, they're no longer just single elements, but they should be considered as a whole. So in the same way, the facade can also be considered as a whole. If you're capable enough, there's a whole new level of freedom that you can explore. For example, if you think about Escher's drawings, it's infinite, doesn't have a limit, doesn't have an end. And you can design a space in the same way. You're no longer drawn to the convention of gravity, but the spaces can be contradicted so that you can imagine now that the non-conventional space in a way that goes beyond the architectural composition. It could be a continuous facade called not gravitational skin that is able to eliminate any reference of the space. The skin should be porous and ambiguous so that it emphasizes on the richness and the spatial quality it can bring. So imagining that you're in a space and the walls and the floors, the ceilings are blurred and they don't have a difference. In this way, the skin becomes the space itself, but it is also a way of communication. It creates an impact to the urban tissue and the city.